if we want to find a reason to be happy, the reason has no reason to be with us. And nature has no reason to provide us with a reason to be happy. And the one who can be automatically happy without any reason is the only one who can live happily in this world. And a person who seeks reasons to be happy or reasons why he is unhappy is damned to live in unhappiness only. He is a self-condemned fellow. Suppose I say, I am unhappy because of this man and that woman. They are not allowing me to be happy. He is an unfortunate fellow because he never allows himself to be happy. There is no one in this world who stops us from being happy. We ourselves condemn us by not caring to bring the three parts of the machine to focus, not being able to select a work which is meaningful. The work we do will be obligatory because the word we use does not belong to the work we do, and the thoughts we think do not belong to either our words or our work. This is the difference between a child and a grown-up fellow. It is the duty of every grown-up fellow to remain a child continuously throughout the life, at the same time growing in wisdom and knowledge. Age should give us experience, wisdom and knowledge, but it should not give us the restriction from being happy. And it all depends upon how we choose our work. See, the child chooses to be happy and jolly. Even while weeping, he is happy because he is independent and he prefers to weep if he wants to weep. And is an adult independent to weep if he wants to weep in the society? He is not so free to weep as the child. That's the way George Bernard Shaw remarks that men weep because men laugh because they can't weep. For example, when we have a slip and a fall on the ground, when something pains here, we get up and smile because we are not independent to weep. The child, if it gets some injury or pain, it is very sincere in thought, word and deed. He can weep because it is time to weep. So we cannot understand what happiness is. That's why we think that weeping people are unhappy and smiling and laughing people are happy. Many times it is far from truth. It is away from truth. Because we see people smiling when they are in great distress and nervousness. We find people laughing, nervous laughter, when they are helpless and they are suffocated inside. If you take them into loneliness and ask them what is the matter and begin to console them, they burst out into weeping because that is the true state in which they are existing. Whereas they conceal it inside and put forth an ugly, nervous laughter, which is opposite to the nature of the laughter of the child. That's why the laugh of a child is most beautiful and delightful. The smile of a child is most delightful. And even the weeping and crying of a child is lovable and most delightful. Because it means what the child means. Whereas even the laugh of a sickly, nervous, elderly person gives us unhappiness and a tragic effect. Because we feel very much for the person who is suffering inside and laughing on the lips. We can understand how much he is suffering inside because he has denied his own expression out. This is the one aspect where strong people take care about themselves. They begin to practice truth speaking as one of the devices of bringing the machine into focus, to bring all the three parts of the machine into focus. This is the best process to follow.